and I'm here with
Gabrielle.
And today we're going to talk about Sandra Botticelli. We're going to start with the Mystic Nativity. It's like, wow. There's so much going on.
Yeah, there's so much going on in this painting.
It's described as a double painting, and that's because it's not your typical nativity kind of painting, mm-hmm. where you see Jesus being born, you know, and Mary and Joseph. You see that right at the middle, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if you look at the whole picture,
there's so much going on.
Exactly. So it has a double meaning. And something that's very interesting is that it combines the themes of, you know, the nativity, the traditional nativity scene, mm-hmm. which is like glory and salvation, you know, Jesus just came to save the world. And combines that with the themes of the Last Judgment, you know, like fear and persecution. So if you take your attention really down here, you see those three men and the three angels kind of raising them up from the ground, like that scene right after, you know, the second coming. You see little, like, demonic figures.
Oh,
you know?
Wow.
Yeah. So you see a lot of demonic figures all around it. And they have really awkward position, those angels, you know, with the men. It literally feels like they're actually, like, helping them.
Yeah, it's weird. They're not really going anywhere.
Exactly. It's kind of really interesting. This, you know, whole different view of what's going on. And if you see the angels here, they have, like, little scrolls, right? And in them, if you zoom in real well, it says in Latin, "Peace on earth to men of goodwill." So it's really interesting to see a painting that's just so much going on there.
A lot of little details hidden.
Yeah. And that's kind of Botticelli, that's what he's going for. You know, he's showing Christ's arrival, but he's also, you know, showing his return. So it's kind of like a past, present, and future.
Wow.
Exactly. So you see everything, kind of the whole plan of redemption, the whole path of religion in this painting. And those figures, you know, up there, and it's really, really beautiful.
They
They're like swirling
like
around.
Angels.
Exactly. And the sky is like opening the whole glory of Christ's arrival, or maybe even his second coming, you know, like the sky is opening. It's just so beautiful, and we have those swirling, you know, angels. You can really sense the happiness and the fear at the same time. It's a lot going on. It represents our spiritual struggle. Because sometimes it's just not, you know, I think that's what Botticelli was trying to go for, is that's the pilgrim's, you know, progress. You know, the pain is also remembered. You know, Christ was born, it's beautiful, but at the same time, there's this whole thing going on, you know, the great, you know, controversy, so.
Even back here, you can see into the forest.
Yeah, no.
Wow.
You can definitely see linear perspective, and you see the attention to detail.
Calumny of Apelles?
Apelles? Apelles? Apelles? I don't know.
This painting, it's so interesting. It's like almost like action stopped.
Yeah, like a picture.
Paused in time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like such a deeper meaning than we like could have imagined. Calumny of Apelles. So Apelles was a painter.
Okay. Yeah.
He was falsely accused of conspiracy against Ptolemy.
Yeah, Ptolemy the Fourth.
The Fourth, which was the leader of Egypt. Right next to Apelles is,
yeah, Apelles is like his hair is being pushed. He's
okay.
Like down, you know.
Okay, so
Apelles
is the one with
three,
his hair.
We have four figures here.
Mm-hmm. Like right above Apelles, and the one who's wearing blue is
represents
the calumny.
Calumny, yes.
Calumny, and calumny means false statement. Envy is right next to calumny, which is that guy who's wearing like kind of like dark.
A darker outfit, yeah.
Yeah, dark outfit. And he represents deceit.
Deceit and malice are right here. So like, malice is
In
red, pinkish, right?
With, like, some kind of yellow underneath her pink. kind of looks like a sheet that she's wearing. But they all seem to kind of be, like, fighting with each other.
Yeah, and try to just keep Apelles down.
Yeah, Apelles, they're trying to keep Apelles down. And then over here, all the way over to the left-hand side, this is Remorse.
Okay.
And Remorse is the figure looking at the Naked Truth, and the Naked Truth is right next to him.
It's so beautiful.
Yes.
It has that contrapposto, the S curve.
Yeah, it has the S curve, and the Naked Truth is like pointing up to the sky, and just it can almost kind of be said that it's like pointing up to the heavens or pointing up
right,
to
the divine.
To the divine, because it is the Naked Truth, which is kind of what like the heavens also represents. The king is sitting on the right-hand side of the picture on a raised throne. He's flanked by the allegorical figures of ignorance and suspicion. Which,
and it's so interesting seeing them whispering to his ears.
Yeah, whispering and kind of like, kind of, manipulate him and pushing him towards like what they want to make him believe.
Mm-hmm.
And, and the rest of the picture, like, there's so much beauty within the building that they're in. There's, like...
It is beautiful.
Mm-hmm. All these pictures that are engraved in the walls. And they're kind of... They're not really pictures. You could tell that they kind of, like, stand out.
Like sculptures.
Out. Yeah, right? Like little sculptures that, like, stand out from the wall. And then also, behind you can see the sky.
Yeah.
Which is kind of like linear perspective.
Yeah, definitely.
But it's so interesting to think that there's so much deeper meaning behind this painting.
And I think that, you know, both of us analyzing and seeing Sandro Botticelli's images, we can see that he uses that a lot. You know, you see his paintings and you're like,
yes.
Oh, okay, but then if you linger on it, there's so much, you know,
meaning,
deeper meaning,
yeah,
and you're just like,
meaning.
Whoa, that's just really awesome.
So that there's a lot going on, and even I really like how they're like on a podium. You can kind of tell like it's on like
you
a higher
it's
level
elevated.
In the picture.
So you see the position of power, you know,
he's
king,
high up there,
his lapels is all the way down,
low, being dragged towards the king. It almost makes you, like, want to find out what happens next.